At about 2:45 this morning near Finch and Sentinel Road. There's no vehicle description at this time. Anyone who witnessed the incident is asked to come forward.
Postal workers will be striking before Wednesday. The Canadian Union of Postal Workers says it's presented Canada Post with new offers. Provided the union gives 72 hours notice, its members are legally allowed to strike starting today. And Canada Post is also allowed to lock out its workers. But union representatives say they haven't presented a notice. The number one sticking point in negotiations involves changes to employee pension plans.
6:80 news time, 1:37. The family of an American woman reported missing in Afghanistan in 2012 with her Canadian husband is pleading for mercy from the couple's captors. Jim and Lynn Coleman say their daughter wrote she'd given birth to two boys while in captivity. James Coleman, in a message to top Taliban commanders, asks for the release of their daughter, her husband, and their children.
And release my daughter, her husband, and their beautiful children.
Caleb Coleman and Joshua Boyle lost touch with their families while traveling in a mountainous region near the Afghan capital of Kabul.
The body of murdered Canadian hostage Robert Hall has reportedly been recovered more than 2 weeks after he was beheaded by Abu Sayyaf extremists in the Philippines. Villagers led troops to where the militants buried Hall's body after killing him on June 13th. His head had been found abandoned outside a Roman Catholic cathedral. Hall is one of two Canadians kidnapped and murdered by the extremists when their ransom demands were not met. Hall and fellow Canadian John Ridstall were kidnapped along with two other people last September.
Federal investigators are examining how a Tesla driving on autopilot collided with a tractor trailer in May. Joshua Brown, who was inside the Tesla, was killed in the crash. The Tesla struck a utility pole in front of Bobby Zapka-Lara's house. He said a witness at the scene of the crash said the Tesla had passed her on the highway minutes before.
She said she was going 85, and when this car just passed her, she was just like,
a statement on Tesla's website describes it as a tragic loss and says the company has opened a preliminary investigation.
Canadians will apparently be keeping a closer eye on their wallets this summer. 6:80's Mike Lloyd's here with a look at just how much we're expected to slash our discretionary spending.
Two-thirds of us say summer is the season where we tend to make more impulsive spending decisions. The poll for CIBC says our plan to spending on fun in the sun is down 25% this year. And the average amount for everything from travel to eating out to a new barbecue is a little over $1,300. Closer to $1,800 last year. A third of us say we'll be sticking very closely to our budget this summer, and half say we're looking for ways to save money. And people, including tax, on some of the top posted on social media, look early and look for deals and discounts, go for the free concerts and festivals, and rather than taking a long road trip, vacation closer to home, day trips and picnics, with a lot of summer flavor. I'm Mike Lloyd.
Coming up in 30 seconds, we'll find out where the price of gas is headed. 6:80 news time, 1:39. Hey, tossers and turners. I'm Christine McGee, co-founder of Sleep Country, and this radio spot is for you. Oh, you too, blanket stealers, sheep counters, and pajama shedders. We've got great news for every Canadian, because right now at the Sleep Country Sleeper Style Sale, there's a perfect mattress for every body at a mind-blowing price. So no matter how you sleep, you'll finally get the great sleep you deserve. Plus, until tomorrow only, get a hot buy seal Eurotel quiz set for just $5.89. Now the 6:80 News gas price update. Enpro predicts the price of gas will not change at midnight, holding at $1.06.9 a liter at most GTA stations.
CFR knows that one line with the green color is hard as hard. There are too many options for us to really overwhelm you. That's why we've launched a new simplified color center with better organized colors and oversized paint chips that are designed to inspire. So it's easier to narrow it down for the color you love. The new CIL Color Center, only at the Home Depot. And right now, save big on CIL Premium Paint Plus Primer, starting at just $19.97 for 3.78 liters. A preliminary mailing rebate on runs July 6th, only at the Home Depot.
I'm here with Bill Coy of Coy Brothers, and I want to know more about these cool new green machines.
You mean you want to know more about the Avant?
Exactly. I want.
I want this to end. Avant multi-purpose compact loaders can do nearly any job. They're equipped with Kubota engines, have 360-degree visibility, and offer over 150 different attachments.
For all your landscaping and construction needs, who wouldn't want an Avant from Coy Brothers?
1919 Wilson Avenue, KOYBRS.com.
Time 1:41 with time for traffic and weather together on the one. Here's Christine Lango.
This report is brought to you by Personal Injury Lawyers, the PIA Law. If you're traveling on the eastbound 401, we have a slowdown from South of Pearson in the Express across to Weston Road. Alternately, Express and Collectors all due to earlier. Eastbound to Dixon, past that is in good shape. Northbound 400, still some volume from Mapleview to north of Exo Road in the Barry area. Don't on the northbound Don Valley if you're traveling to the southbound 404 Don Valley is busy approaching the 401 Express, down to about Lawrence. No problems on the westbound Gardner heading out of downtown. Westbound QEW that remains busy from Doorbound to Brandt, and that Fort Erie bound from Elizabeth Way is heavy, approaching Burlington Street to pass through Land Road and slow going to Beansville as well. Westbound Dundas ramp to northbound 427 that has been closed for construction this afternoon. On the eastbound Gardner, delays from Park Sun to the Spadina ramp. Don't forget we have church closed from Carlton to Hayes, 4 High Street South, and Melton closed from Church to Jarvis for festivities as well. And for the Dyke March, Bloor is closed from Young to Church and Young closed from Bloor. If you are traveling along Wellesley, or rather Church Street, we have a closure from Carlton to Hayden, and that's going to be until Monday morning at about 6 o'clock when it should reopen. Please just want to get a safe one. PIA Law and 910 remind you there is no excuse for impaired driving ever. Visit PIALaw.ca. Now the latest forecast, here's meteorologist Brian Hill.
First, it's just a beautiful weekend of the Gulf today. We'll mix with 7 o'clock, the gas down 25 with high UV index. That's a high level of 7 or 27. We'll begin to play with 14. Nice and, well, pleasant, what do you put it that way? Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, all 3 days. Last week, maybe 7, Monday, 30. Downtown, Cincinnati is 24. Your system is only now 24 degrees. Northwesterly winds at 26, gusts to 37. And now, two guys at 25.
Still ahead on 680 News, Rose Reisman talks about sweeteners and this week's food fight. 680 News time, 1:43.
Working at heights, training requirements are the law in Ontario. If you're an employer who has workers who work at heights in construction, make sure they're trained. If you're a homeowner, hiring a contractor will have workers working at heights, such as replacing a roof, you should ask if they have the training and how they'll work safely. To find out more, visit ontario.ca/working at heights. Paid for by the Government of Ontario.
Thanks for calling my home comfort.
Help, our air conditioner broke down and we're about to downgrade our summer vacation to buy a new one.
Oh, don't do that yet. Buy a select AC and make no monthly payments until October 1st of next year.
Yes, our vacation is back on.
Instead of?
We've been on adventure, but kids are kind of scared of her, actually.
Get a select AC and make no monthly payments until October 1st, 2017. Go to 1-866 Reliance or visit reliancehomecomfort.com for details. Reliance, we're not comfortable until you are. Conditions apply. Full AC, no monthly payments for 15 months. Issued to cruise from October 1st, 2017.
This is all news radio. 680 News.
A sunny sky in downtown Toronto. It's 24 degrees. Good afternoon from the 680 News Broadcast Center. I'm Sarah Harris. Your top stories this hour. Cities are wrapping up this weekend and for the big parade tomorrow. One of the month's premier events is happening this afternoon. The annual Tides March gets underway in about 15 minutes' time at Church and Store.